Hi, this is Danica, and it's been a while when my last video that I have this camera on me, so a bit shy type today. But in this channel, I do design and teach other people how to use WordPress for their online membership and online training courses. Now, I want to start addressing your questions because I did receive your comments with different questions, so I'm gonna start addressing those one by one, and I'm also gonna start sharing more tips as I work on different projects. And this one, I really want to highlight this because it's been, I think I noticed that this issue is present in multiple projects that I handle. So whenever we jump in and help a client, we notice that in the LearnDash settings, their course is set to open. So what I mean by that is when you see this message, this one. So if you see this message in your course, that's one of the indicator that it is open. We're also going to check out how it looks in the settings and how to correct. And I'm also going to share an example why I don't recommend you do it this way. I always recommend you set it to close or buy now or something, but not open. Okay, so let's just check out this message here. If we check this one, it says, warning, because your course is marked as open, all site members will be enrolled in it regardless on the tags or membership. We recommend setting your site as closed. And then there's a click here for more information. Now, this setup, this website, I'm just going to blur it out because we're still working on the content. But this website, it is using a combination of LearnDash with Memberium and then Memberium for Keap. So there's two versions in Memberium that it works. So Memberium for ActiveCampaign and Memberium for Keap, but it should be similar in functionality. So if you're using ActiveCampaign or Keap with Memberium, it should be the same. Now, the scenario here is, in the past video, I did show you how to create a table for widget engine to, that table was holding members' progress because what the client is trying to do is once the website is launched, they want to follow up on their members via Keap or Infusionsoft and send them an email that, hey, we saw that your latest progress is this lesson or this section of the course, and encourage them to continue and so on. So that's what we're trying to pull. So far, we've able to achieve that with Jet Engine as well. But there was a question why the total number does not make sense compared to their sales data or the record for how many members they have in this course. So we start digging more other than that table that we have worked on. I also tried to use and take advantage on the LearnDash Pro panel because they have that and exported those contacts who are like marked as not started, in progress and completed. So you could also pull that in from LearnDash directly and it will give you a CSV file with some data of their course, where they have left, so last progress or last step, you're gonna see that. So we've used that CSV file and compare the numbers and still it doesn't make sense because there were just a lot of contacts inside the not started list. So we were checking. Now, for this case, again, the course is set to open when I check. At first, I did not check this, their live site because we have staging site that we have configured properly. And then we exported the data from their live site. And then we found out that in the live site, it is set to open. So I want to make sure I have a video regarding this, that when you're creating a course, never set it to open. Even if it's not yet ready, like even if you're just testing it out, always set it to close. It's more safe with that one. And it's gonna prevent issues like this. In the long run, it's gonna help you. Maybe later you're really don't worry on this kind of data, but later on, once you take advantage on the pro panel functionality from LearnDash in terms of reporting, even Uncanny or Wisdom Labs, this wrong data will show up. So always set it to close. Really, that's just the tip. That's only my major tip for this video, but let me just move on to the next page. So this is the section, if you edit a course, there is the settings tab, right? So go to that settings, and as you can see, this one is set to open, right? This is set to open. So what you should always do is set it to closed. This one, set it to closed. This one. So always set it to close, even if you're not yet sure, even if it's not yet ready, even if you're still working on it, set it to close, because it will make sure your data in the reporting will be clean later on. So once you set it to close, update it. Don't forget to hit this update button and you should be good to go. Okay, so here's another example for how it looks from the user's data side. We're just gonna use the profile page from the WordPress dashboard. But as you can see here, this one, so it says status. So I'm just blurring out the titles and stuff, but the status is set to not started, and then there's a completion number out of total and so on. But supposedly, this member, me myself as an admin, I don't have the right tag from Memberium. Well, even if we test it in subscriber side or member side, it was exactly similar. But as a login user, I didn't have that required tag. And of course, I'm an admin by default. I'm going to get access to everything because it is the default on settings and LearnDash, which you can also turn off. But even for subscribers, this is what's happening. So this data here is present to those users, even if they don't have, supposedly they don't have the right access and did not purchase the course. So it's messing up the reporting. Okay, so in this screen, we are looking at the Keap or Infusionsoft data that I was working on. So in here, we've able to export the in progress, this one, and we have the not started and completed. And then if I check, we have 366, we have 842 not started, and then we have this completed. Okay, so this number again did not make sense. So what I've done is I have first created a report. So we created a report in Keap and check out those contact who has that not started tag, and then filter it with tag from the membership level or from the course. So if they don't have any of those tags, then we consider them as they haven't purchased really the course and was just part of this wrong data that got mixed up because the course was set to open. So in total, we have 713 here, and after that, I tagged those contacts and I created another report from that. So these are now contacts with in progress, not started or completed tag, but is not part of that 700 plus that I have found out, which I tag manually with don't include. So I hope this video helps. Again, combination with LearnDash and Memberium, it's very powerful. You could do a lot. I even really like their shortcode because I could do a lot of gamification without a help of a third party app. But just because you have protected your course with a Memberium tag from Keap or ActiveCampaign doesn't mean it's not gonna mess up with your report in WordPress. So you need to make sure that it's clean in LearnDash and then protect it properly as well in Memberium. Because there's a settings in LearnDash that when they have this tag, then auto-enroll them. That means even if your LearnDash course is set to close, if they have that tag, they will be auto-enrolled. So you can do this and use that in your purchase funnel for sure. But yeah, set your courses to close even if it's not yet ready or you're still working on something so that it doesn't mess up your report. Again, I hope this video helps. If you have any question regarding this topic, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I can. These two apps are two of my favorite apps that I always use for my projects. So I really want to address this not so common issue but exists in the projects that I have worked with. And yeah, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.